most people in America are looking for, how do I make a life worth living and retirement having? Well, in order to do that, we have to be working to our highest level of achievement. And I've already been a CEO of my company for many years, although I never really felt comfortable using that title because it implies like I'm some mega corporation, which I wasn't. I was just a micro business, as we call in our community back home. The truth is, my job was helping people who were like me to produce better marketing. And I did that through training, and I did that through graphic design, and I did that through helping them capture a video that would promote them at that time. But what I also learned through the being a marketing strategist and a person who is helping people to sell their companies is that sometimes the CEOs of those companies, or the small business owners of those companies, or the independent sales professional of those proper national companies, because let's face it, a financial planner is representing certain types of vendors, didn't always agree with my marketing ideas for them. My marketing ideas tend to be bold because you want your card remembered so that when a person's going, wait a minute, I met that guy, what does his card look like? When they're running through a stack of 200 business cards, that card falls out immediately in their mind and they can pick up that card and call that person. And that's the whole purpose of a business card. The whole purpose of a business card is to have someone pick up a phone and call you for giving you the opportunity to win a sales job, basically. And most of my business cards and most of my clients were encouraged to have dual-sided cards so that they could put content on the back. Now, if you're somebody like me, I'm not going to list Japanese on the back of my marketing card. I'm not going to list my forum automatically to anyone that I meet because we were a very collect group. We had very specific people who had membership in our group, and I had to be careful of who I was inviting out to hear a speaker, so I didn't piss off my members and they would feel competition in that. Most networking groups across the Midwest, at least, have sort of a no competition, no compete principle for their members, that there's only going to be one person from that industry represented. So the reality is, even though I started my forum a little bit with another graphic designer, he sort of pissed all over me, took my ideas to another fledgling organization, and literally I got fucked. So I'm very sensitive to intellectual property theft. That guy screwed me out of a lot, but he took it to the right people who played with it and ran with it, and they produced hundreds of thousands of dollars off that idea of small groups that was mine. But openly, that's the truth over time. In America, we have rights, but the person that's just willy-nilly clipping my video is violating federal law. And why are they doing that? They're trying to make me fall. Because why else would they be doing it? Is it just a game, like it's a video game for them, and they're trying to teach themselves editing? At no fucking time did I give them the rights to my business, to play in my company, to play in my intellectual brand, to play in what's representing me at all.